Second.
Students, today we will be dealing with module 1, which is diode and its applications. Under this chapter, you need to study what do you mean by PN junction, what do you mean by forward biasing and reverse biasing of PN junction, its characteristics and the types of PN junction. After studying the types of the PN junction, you are going to study the application of a PN junction, that is diode. PN junction is nothing but the diode, its application as a rectifier. So you will be studying what is rectifier, its types and some of its derivations. These derivations are concerned with these rectifiers. Derivations, problems on rectifiers and some other diodes. Other than this PN junction diode, you will be studying Zener diode, photodiode and what do you mean by photocoupler. You will be studying all these under the same chapter, which is module 1, diode and applications. First, we will see what is this PN junction. In your second PUC, you people have studied what do you mean by PN junction. Hope if you remember, this PN junction is nothing but combination of P-type semiconductor with N-type semiconductor, which is going to give you PN junction. And here we are going to have two terminals for this. One is going to be anode, another one is going to be cathode. So this PN junction is nothing but our diode. So what is diode? Diode is nothing but PN junction having two terminals, anode and cathode. What is P? P is a semiconductor material. N is also a type of semiconductor material. When you combine this P type with N type, we will get a PN junction, which we are going to call it as diode. Now, symbol of diode is this. This is the symbol of diode. This is the anode terminal and this is the cathode terminal. This is diode. Now, after knowing what is this PN junction, which is nothing but a diode and its symbol, we will see what do you mean by biasing of a diode. What do you mean by biasing of a diode? What do you mean by biasing of a diode is between the two terminals of diode. Between the two terminals of diode, you are going to connect external supply. That is called bias. That is, if you take a diode like this, symbol I am taking, which is anode and cathode, you are going to connect a supply here. You may connect the supply like this. Or, okay, suppose if you have connected it like this. This is positive terminal of a supply, this is negative terminal of a supply. Connecting supply across the terminals of a diode is called biasing of a diode. So this biasing of a diode, you can classify this one as forward biasing of a diode and reverse biasing of a diode. So connecting the external supply between the terminals is biasing. By connecting this external supply, you can say that diode is forward biased and diode is reverse biased. When do you say the diode is forward biased? If the anode of a diode is connected to positive terminal of a battery and cathode is connected to negative terminal of a diode, then we say it is forward bias. Hope you understand. Anode to positive, cathode to negative terminal of a diode. Reverse bias will be reverse of this one. That is, if you make this one a negative and this as a positive, so this is negative, positive terminal of a diode. Anode is connected to negative terminal of a diode and cathode is connected to positive terminal of a diode. If you connect it like this, it is going to be a reverse bias. So, anode should be connected to positive terminal of a diode, cathode should be connected to negative terminal of a diode, which is going to give you forward biasing of a diode. If you connect the anode to negative terminal of a supply and cathode to positive terminal of a supply, then it will form this is. Hope you understand what do you mean by forward biasing and reverse biasing of a diode. After this, you will be studying the PN junction under no bias, means when there is no external supply connected across the terminals of a diode, how diode will be operating or what will be the behavior of a diode that you are going to have. Suppose I draw this, this is P, this is N. So this is under no bias. I say under no bias, that is diode under no bias, means no supply connected across the terminals of a diode. You know, P will be having holes moving number, N will be having electrons. Because these are doped semiconductors. What do you mean by doping? Adding external impurities to the pure semiconductor material to get p-type and n-type. So when you dope them, here the number of holes will be more, here the number of electrons will be more. Now, when you join p-type material with n-type material to get a p-n junction, what happens is diffusion starts. What do you mean by diffusion? That is crossing of holes towards this side and crossing of electrons towards this junction. That is, holes tend to cross the junction towards the negative electrons and negative electrons tend to move towards the positive hole. So there will be a force of attraction. Therefore, these holes start diffusing across the junction and they move towards again. Electrons diffuse across the junction and enter into p-type. So now what happens when this hole is leaving this p-type and it is coming here, it is going to leave a positive ion here at its place. This is p, this is n, right? So here number of holes are there, here number of electrons are there. Suppose this hole is moving this side, it is coming this side, means it is going to leave a negative ion at its place. Why negative ion? Atom as a neutral, as a whole, we consider it as a neutral. When this atom loses one hole, this charge will be more, which is called negative ion. Similarly, when this electron diffuses into p-type, it is going to leave a positive ion here. Because one electron is lost, so it is going to leave a positive ion here. Like this, if this enters into n-type, here negative ion will be created. If an electron present here, it comes this side, positive ion. Like this, suppose three electrons have diffused this side, so it will be having three positive ions. If three holes have crossed this junction and come this side, they are going to have three negative ions. Like this, as the diffusion continues, you will be having a layer of negative ions this side and a layer of positive ions on this side. So now what happens? After these ions have formed near the junction, further diffusion becomes difficult here. Why further diffusion? Further diffusion means further crossing of these holes this side, electrons passing this side, it becomes difficult. By means, this is also positively charged hole. When it tends to cross this junction and come here, this is going to oppose. This is also positively charged. This opposes the coming of this hole this side. Similarly, when holes, they tend to move this side, electrons tend to move this side, electrons, negatively charged particle, when it tends to cross this junction, this is opposed by the negative charge ion here. Therefore, diffusion is going to stop. So, this layer which is going to stop the diffusion, which is going to be a barrier, which is going to stop the diffusion or which is going to barrier the diffusion, we call this one as potential barrier or barrier potential, you can say. Better we will say this one as barrier potential. So this is going to be an electron field here, electric field, negative, positive. So this is going to be an electric field here, that is we call it as a potential, which is going to act as a barrier by diffusion stops because of potential barrier or barrier potential. Why there will be a potential barrier? Initially, when we join these two, they tend to move this side, holes and electrons, they tend to move this side. As this hole leaves its place, positive ion is created. If this leaves, positive ion is created. If this leaves its place and comes here, negative ion will be created. Suppose these are the holes which have moved this side, these are the electrons which have moved this side. They have created positive ions and negative ions. Layer of positive and negative ions near the junction. So this is going to stop the further diffusion. That is, electrons cannot cross this junction and come here because this negative charge opposes this one. Similarly, this positive charge, it is going to positive ion, it is going to oppose the crossing of this hole this side. So diffusion stops. As this is going to be a barrier for the diffusion, we call this one as potential barrier. It is going to have electric field here. So we can consider this one as layer of positive and negative ions, electric field. That is potential. We can call this one as barrier potential. So this is the condition of the diode or a PN junction. When we have applied no supply, nothing is given between the terminals of a PN junction under no bias. Now this condition only we explain by forward biasing. Forward biasing is what? Remember, in most of the question is explain PN junction under forward bias and reverse bias conditions. In many of the question papers which are already provided to you, you can see PN junction under forward bias and reverse bias condition is asked. Means you have to take the PN junction which is under no bias. Now this is the condition of a PN junction which is under no bias. So I will take that. This is P type, N type. Here the layer of ions is formed, negative ions. Here it is, positive ions. Now, you are going to bias this one, forward bias. First condition is, we consider only the forward biasing of a diode. Forward biasing means, this is P has to be connected to positive terminal of a battery, N has to be connected to negative terminal of a battery. Now, this is forward bias. Here we will be having here we will be having electrons, right? Now, when this is connected, what might happen here? You can see these are positively charged poles. Here is a positive terminal. What might happen? Force of attraction or force of repulsion? Yes, definitely it is going to be a force of repulsion. Positive charge repelling the positively charged poles. So these poles cannot move this side, but they are forced to move to this side. Negative. Electrons negatively charged. Again, the electrons cannot reach this terminal because force of repulsion. So, these cannot enter like this, but they are forced to move to this side. Now, you increase this voltage, whatever supply you have given, you increase it. As you increase it, the force of repulsion will be more, means these are forced to enter here and cross the junction. If you increase this, again because of this high negative supply, these electrons are forced to cross this junction. So now we are going to start the diffusion. So now the diffusion has started. The diffusion has started. Again, have got all the holes. Holes attracted by the negative, they start moving like this. Or you can consider the electrons getting attracted by this positive terminal, they start moving like this, which is nothing but the current. Current can flow. So, what is the conclusion under forward bias, diffusion? Again, stars means I starts to flow. So, what you can say, I starts to flow through the PN junction means the load is on. PN junction, I starts to flow through the PN junction means diode is on. There is a current through the diode. So, under forward bias, diode is going to be on. Same thing you consider now under reverse bias. You take the PN junction. This is P and N. So, here ions are there. Ions. N reverse bias. It is negative, positive. This was positive, negative. Now it is negative, positive. Reverse bias. Now you have holes. You have electrons. So, negative. Holes positively charged. They are attracted. They are attracted. Electrons. They are again attracted. So, hole is leaving. Hole is leaving. So one more. Hole is leaving. This hole is coming this side. This hole is leaving its space. Electrons are leaving their space. So the layer of positive and negative ions is increased. So the width of the depletion layer, this width, this was depletion layer or potential depletion layer, yes, I forgot to tell you, this layer is also called depletion layer here, means it is depleted of charge carriers. There are no charge carriers here, only ions are there. So, depletion layer means the layer or the region, depletion region also you can say, which is depleted, means there are no charge carriers, therefore it is depletion region. So, this depletion region, which was only this much, when you reverse bias it, it increases. Depletion layer width increases. So, when depletion layer width increases, no crossing of electrons and holes, no movement external to this. So, what is the conclusion? In the forward bias, you have given this conclusion. Now, in the reverse bias, you can say diffusion again starts means diffusion completely stops. Why diffusion completely stops? Because width of the depletion layer goes on increasing. Here, why diffusion again starts? Depletion layer width, it reduces. So here, in the reverse bias, diffusion completely stops. I cannot flow. That is, current cannot flow. When current cannot flow through the PN junction means current cannot flow through the diode, you can say. So diode is going to be. This is the conclusion. You should remember, when diode is forward biased, it will conduct the current. Diode is on. Remember this, it is going to help you to go to the path concepts. So, diode is on when it is forward biased, diode is off under reverse bias. So, this is the conclusion we have derived. And this explanation will be asked. Remember, PN junction under forward bias and reverse bias condition. That time you have to explain how the width of the depletion region goes on decreasing and how the diffusion starts. Here, how under reverse bias, how the width of the depletion layer goes on increasing and how the diffusion completely stops. Now, after studying this, cannot flow. This is off. This is on. Diode forward bias, diode reverse bias. Now, this one. When we apply a voltage here, what is the current flowing? How the current flows? When we apply a negative voltage, how? What is the condition of a current flow? Showing that the relationship between the voltage applied and the current flow through the diode. The relationship between the voltage applied across the terminals and the current flowing through the diode is nothing but the characteristics of a diode. That is V versus I you are going to show. V versus I. So voltage is taken on this axis, current is taken on this axis for the forward bias. So what we have seen is it will start conducting only when the depletion layer completely disappears. So initially when we give the voltage, the current, whatever amount of current, it will be very less. So if you go on increasing the voltage, the current initially will be very less, means diode conduction will be very less. So you are increasing in steps 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, something like this. And at one particular point, current suddenly increases. Current suddenly increases at one particular voltage. Here, one particular voltage, current suddenly increases. After that, if you increase the voltage corresponding to that, current does not increase. But there should be a limit here. So, once again, properly I can draw here. Yes, when it is forward bias, current starts to flow. But when this is of less value, lower current will be there, almost negligible current. At a particular voltage, the current goes on increasing. So, till this voltage, you have applied so many voltages here, the current was only this much, it was varying only this. But at our particular voltage, current abruptly increased. It was at this level. From this level to this level, it has jumped. Okay? As you go on increasing, you are going to get an increase in the current. So, this voltage at which there is sudden increase in the current, at this voltage at which there is sudden increase in the current, this voltage, we call this one as knee voltage or cut-in voltage. So, what will be the voltage? Means, what will be the value of this voltage? At which the flow of current through this diode will be very high. That value is 0.7 volts if the PN junction you have used in a P-type semiconductor material and N-type semiconductor material. If those materials are made up of silicon, then till 0.7 volts current will be very less. When you reach 0.7 volts, current suddenly increases. And it is going to be lesser than this, that is 0.3 volts. So these are the knee voltages when it is forward bias, you should remember. In solving problems, you need to use these values. Knee voltage or cutting voltage or forward breakdown voltage. Also you can call this one as forward breakdown voltage. This value is this. This is forward characteristics. Here I have told you, as you go on increasing the voltage, the current goes on increasing after this knee voltage. But there should be a limit. Current is increasing, it is okay for increasing the voltage. But if the current crosses its limit, if it goes beyond the limit, it may cause damage to the diode. Here we have to take. Now this is reverse characteristics. Means when diode is reverse bias. This was reverse bias. Current is reverse bias, means voltage, negative voltage, reverse voltage we have applied, and we talk about the reverse current. So when a negative, we have seen when it is reverse bias, there is no flow of current through the diode. But some leakage current will be flowing through the diode when it is reverse bias. This current we can show it is due to the minority charge current. Very, very negligibly small current you can show. But at one particular voltage, the current may suddenly increase. That is reverse, high reverse current. High reverse current, if you allow it to flow, it because it is reverse current. Till this point it is okay. Till this point diode is safe. Though there is no current, no harm to the diode, no current to the diode. But from this voltage if you come, high reverse current flows and it may damage the diode. So this is called reverse breakdown voltage. So there is forward breakdown voltage also, reverse breakdown voltage also. Now the difference between the forward breakdown voltage and the reverse breakdown voltage. Where is the harm to the diode? Is there any harm for the forward breakdown voltage? No. During forward breakdown voltage, there is no harm, there is no loss, there is a gain. Current through the diode suddenly increases at the forward breakdown voltage. After that also, we get a good amount of current through the diode. But here, reverse breakdown voltage means high reverse current we get, which is going to damage the diode. So, this is about the characteristics of PN junction.
AC
positive half cycle. This is half, this is half. During positive half cycle, this end is going to be positive, this end is going to be negative. So this end I will name it as A, this end I will name it as B. So during positive half cycle, point A will be positive, point B will be negative. So this is our anode, this is our cathode. Anode is connected to this is point B. And this is point B. So anode is connected to positive, cathode will be connected to negative. So what is the condition of a diode? Diode is, I can write here, point A will be positive, point B will be negative. From this what we analyze, diode is forward bias means diode is on. When diode is on, current flows. Current flows means whatever input you have given, this is given as the input to a diode. Now diode is allowing this to pass and come at the output side. It is allowing everything, whatever is given as its input, we are getting at its output. Because diode is in a condition to conduct. This is the output voltage. So this part you are getting as it is at the output side. Now for this negative, just think, for a negative, now the case reverses. This is going to be negative, this is going to be positive. Now anode connected to negative, cathode connected to positive means diode is going to be, A is going to be negative, B is going to be positive. So diode is reverse bias, it was forward bias here. So when it is reverse bias, we already know diode cannot conduct, the diode is going to be off. So when it is off, this part, whatever we have given as an input to a diode, it will not appear. It will not appear means output is going to be zero. Again for this part, same condition as this, we will get this part because diode is going to be forward. For this, diode is going to be reverse. So we are not going to get. So this is going to be my output for a half gate rectifier. Why it is called half gate? Now you can understand. Full gate means this half cycle plus this half cycle. But in the output, I am getting only one half cycle. Out of two, I am getting only one half cycle. Therefore, it is half cycle of half gate rectifier. So this is half gate rectifier. And here, before we go to the next type, why we need to go for the next type, that is full wave rectifier, we should discuss. So taking up two points, one is efficiency and ripple factor. I'm going to explain why we do not prefer this and we go for the full wave rectifier. That means, what is efficiency? Efficiency of anything is whatever input you have given, out of that how much output you are getting. That is the efficiency. So here, AC input you have given, I want my diode to convert complete AC into DC. But practically which is not possible. 100% of AC should get converted into DC, which is not practically possible. That is called efficiency. Efficiency, it is denoted by letter ME factor. How that is done? AC input is there. Out of that, how much is converted into DC? If you see this, it is going to be very less. If you take this in percentage, it is going to be only 40.8%. Not even 50% of the AC got converted into DC output. Not even 50% of the AC input is got converted into DC output. So what we say, efficiency of a half-wave rectifier is very poor, very less. Similarly, what is ripple? Ripple factor, in short, you can write it as RF here. What is ripple factor? Here, what I expect is, I expect pure DC at the output side. I expect pure DC at the output side. But are the advantages of voltage rectifier, whereas these two are the disadvantages of half-wave rectifier. So, disadvantages of half-wave rectifier, we have overcome them in full-wave rectifier. So, we go for the study of full-wave rectifier. These efficiency and ripple factor are very important concepts as far as rectifiers are concerned. You should clearly know the difference between the efficiency and the ripple factor. Now, coming to the full wave rectifier, we have two types, center tap and bridge type. Center tap and bridge type, now we go for center tap. So, in the halfway, we have used one diode, now we will be using two diodes. So, here we have transformer, here will be a output. I am considering output from the center of the secondary of the transformer. Output is tapped from the center of the secondary. Therefore, it is called center tap. Center of the secondary of a transformer, we have tapped the output. We are taking output at this part. Therefore, it is called center tap. Again, this is going to be your AC input, and here you will be having DC output. This you can call it as diode D1, this you can call it as diode D2. So, instead of one diode, we are using two diodes in center tap, full wave rectifier. Why this is called center tap means from the center of the secondary, we have tapped the output. Therefore, it is called center. Again, consider these points as A, this point as B, and start analyzing how you have started for this. AC, yes. AC, no. Positive half cycle. During positive half cycle, what might happen? Positive half cycle. This is positive, this is negative. Check the condition of both of us. D1. Anode to positive, cathode to negative. Anode to negative, cathode to positive. So this is forward bias, this is the reverse bias. Hope you can understand. During forward bias, what is happening? D1 forward, positive half cycle. During positive, D1 forward bias, D2 reverse bias. So this is off, this is on. Will you get the output? Yes, as one diode is on, calculating the output to this diode, how the current flows? Current cannot come here as this is reverse bias. It will not allow the flow of current. So, the current will be flowing like this. So, whatever you have given as an input, that you will be getting as an output due to diode D1 only. This is the output voltage. Now, check this negative. Now, at this, this is going to be negative. This is going to be positive. Now, this is connected. Anode is connected to negative. This is connected to positive means this is off, whereas this anode is connected to positive and this is going to be negative means now this is going to be on. So, during negative half cycle, what do you write? During negative half cycle. D1 is reverse bias, therefore it is off. D2 is forward bias, therefore it is on. So, we will get the output because of this. Output, current starts to flow as this is on. Current cannot go here, again it will do this. So, through the diode D2, we are getting. But how do we draw the output here? Always we tend to draw the output here because this is the input given. D2 should pass this input. But we are not going to draw it here. Just check the current direction, whether this diode is on or this diode is on. The flow of current is in the same direction. So, output is also in the same direction. This is oxygen, negative oxygen in the output, therefore it is called full wave activity. Hope you understood this. This is center tap full wave rectifier. Next, coming to the last type, that is bridge type full wave rectifier. Bridge type means we are going to connect the diodes in the bridge type. Four diodes we have used, you can say V1, V2, V3, or you can say V1, V2, I'll say this. V1, V2, I'll say this one as V2, V2. Why we have named like this, you will understand later. So, between these two, I'll be applying the input voltage. Right? How do I apply input voltage? Through a transformer. You have seen this in the last 2 rectifiers. So this is AC across this. Now I should get out. Now remaining 2 terminals. Opposite terminals you can take and you will get the output. Drawing these diodes is very, very important. Now, again for the same analysis. During positive half cycle, between these 2 points you have connected the input, so name them as A and B. What is A? A is going to be positive, A is going to be positive, this is going to be negative. Just to check what are the conditions of all the 4 nodes. This is positive, connected to anode. Connected to anode, this is connected to cathode, means which diode is on? D3 is on. Next, this is negative. Negative connected to anode, negative connected to cathode. Which diode is on? This diode is on. So, this diode and this diode, they are off. They are not conducting because they are reverse poles. But you can understand this. Positive connected to anode, positive connected to cathode. Only this is forward bias, this is reverse poles. Negative connected to cathode. Forward bias in the diode. So, in the conduction, there is no any active part from these 2 dots. So, only conduction happens to D3 and D4. So, I can write during forward bias. Only D3 and D4 are forward bias. D1 and D2 are reverse bias. Or, in the notes, you will get this one as D1 and D2, this one as D2 and D3. Okay, I do it as D1 and D2. Don't be confused. This diode I will name it as D3 and D4. So, D3, D4, reverse bias, D1, D2, forward bias. Now, this is this one. These 2 were conducting. Now, I have changed the name. D1 and D2, D3 and D4 are not conducting. So, how do you get the output? This is conducting. So, the current starts to flow like this. It will flow here. Then it cannot come as this is off. It will go here. Next current comes. Next current comes. Current cannot go here as this is off. It will come here. Current cannot go here as this is off. So, current. We are getting the current here. So, this is nothing but this part of the current. You are getting. We had given this as an input. You are getting this as an output. Because of which diodes? D1 and D2. Because only D1 and D2 are positives. Now, check the negative part. Now, we know all these. Right? Now, for the negative half cycle. This end is going to be negative, this end is going to be positive. A negative, B positive. Now, check the condition for the negative to anode. So, reverse bias, forward bias, reverse bias, forward bias. cannot go here because this is off now. T1 is off. It will come here. So current is in the same direction as before. During the first 2 half cycle, we had got the current direction this way. So now during negative half cycle also, current will be like this only. So during negative half cycle also, current we will be drawing in the same direction as the previous one, but due to other two waves. After this, it will come here. It cannot go here as this is off. It will go this here. Are being